everyone, welcome to my show HD Reviews. Today we are here to review the latest Bollywood film that has been released, The Ghazi Attack. This is actually a bilingual film which is simultaneously released in Telugu and Hindi, and it will also be dubbed into Tamil. It stars Rana Raghavati, Atul Kulkarni, KK Menon, Tapasi Pannu, Rahul Singh and a lot of fantastic actors like the recently deceased Mr. Om Puri. We'll be coming to the performance in a while. Jumping to the story is unofficially based during the 1971 war between India and Pakistan. Also, there was a war between East Pakistan and West Pakistan. I need to mention here, there is so a disclaimer at the beginning of the film that it is a work of fiction and simply inspired, but it's unofficially based about the mysterious sinking of PNS Ghazi and the possible involvement of INS Rajput, whose name has been changed to S-21, submarine S-21 in this film. Now coming to the story, the first part of this film takes time to establish his character. The character of Rana Raghavati is Lieutenant Arjun and the character of KK Menon is Captain Singh. So Captain Singh is a very hot-headed person. The solution for him, for everything, is just war. He just needs to shoot everyone and gets the job done. But that's not how it happens, is it? So completely contrary to his character is the character of Rana Raghavati. So his character is written as a very, very calm person, and he has been particularly sent to keep Captain Singh on check. I don't know if they have written the character of Rana Raghavati because it goes out perfectly with his monotonous and dull note, but anyways, it suits him because he has a single note throughout the film, apart from few parts where he goes like completely angry. Anyways, there is also a character of Debras played by Atul Kulkarni. I think he's the best performer of this film. And there is a small role played by Om Puri. And the character played by Rahul Singh is of the Pakistani general. And I think it has been unnecessarily written in a hilarious way. And I didn't personally like it. Anyways, as I said, the first part takes its time to establish the situation, the tension and the confrontation between the each characters. And it is good. The second part goes to the direction where personally I was waiting for, because from the trailers I was really excited because this is the first submarine film in India. So I was really excited. Ooh, we'll be having submarine wars. This submarine is going to suit this one. That's going to be awesome. So I was really waiting for that, and the second part shifts mostly to that. And there is a cat and mouse game. So overall the story is good, certainly good. It's not a perfect story. I'll be giving 1.5 out of 2 for the story. The screenplay? Yes, the screenplay is alright, but I think it could have been better. There are certain portions in this film which I think were completely unnecessary and could have been easily chopped off. That would have made the runtime a little bit more crisper and the entire experience a more thrilling, whatever. So I'll give you an average score of 1/2 for the screenplay. Now coming to the dialogue, see, this is a patriotic film, so the dialogues like Sare Jahan Se Acha, Hindustan Hamara, or the national anthem, these are obvious and it is there, and I don't have any problem with that. I am happy with that. But what I have a problem is at certain person, this film goes a little bit over dramatic or melodramatic. I don't particularly encourage such kind of dialogues in particularly patriotic films. I want it as much realistic as possible. But it's okay, dialogue is not bad. There are certain sequences where the dialogue is extremely witty. Like I'll be giving a good mark of 1.5 out of 2 for the dialogues. So this is about the story, screenplay and dialogue. Now coming to acting and direction, the next two important segment. The film certainly cast fantastic actors. Starting from KK Menon to Tapasi Pannu, these are wonderful actors. KK Menon, as I said, is a fantastic actor, but here he is just about above average. I was expecting more of him. At certain scenes, he goes a little bit overboard and a little bit melodramatic, but it's okay. I would have been happy if you would have done it a little bit more realistic. Maybe the director advised him to do that way. Anyways, the character of Rana Raghavati, as I said, is of a calm person, and he has a single note in most of his films and also in this film, apart in some scenes where he goes there, he turns out to be an angry young man, and that suits completely to his Hulk physique. Anyways, coming to the character of Atul Kulkarni, I think he's the best performer of this film. His character's name is Devraj, and he's the peacemaker in this film. And Om Puri, in a short role, does a good job. Rahul Singh, he's a good actor, but I think he has been wasted here because I don't understand why the Pakistani characters are written in a funny way. That doesn't mean I like them or hate them. That's a completely different issue. But it would have been more better if his character would have been written a little bit more intelligently, and his character would have been a little bit more intelligent. That would have made the film a different experience altogether. Tapasi Pannu, see, I have become a fan of her in recent times because starting from Chasme Paddu to Baby to Pink, which has been recently released, to the upcoming Naam Sabana, and also the film that released this year, Running Sadi, which is a good film. I'll be reviewing that in my next review. She has been choosing good films consistently. But here I think this is a mismatch role for her. Her character does not make any sense. She's playing the character of Ananya, a Bangladeshi refugee that the submarine of Indian submarine find in the sea. So she completely stays stunned or like this. At a corner, she's sitting like this, watching everyone go berserk. It was very, very awkward and complete waste of a talent. Coming back to the performance, I'll be giving 1.5. The performances are good out of 2. The direction is done by Sankalp Reddy. First, I need to appreciate him and give a pat on his back because this is a very, very sensitive and a difficult topic to deal with. Particularly, see, these are all classified information. These were not released anyway. So, first of all, to decide to deal with this topic is a big step, and he has done a good job. Where the film falters is, I'll be coming to that, is the technical aspects. But in direction, it's good. Yes, there are certain portions in this film which could have easily been chopped off, but that's fine. I'll be going with 1.5 up to 2 for the direction. Now, coming to the technical aspects of this film. Starting with the music and background score, there is no music in this film. The background score is okay. So, 1 by 2, it's completely average. So now coming to the cinematography is good. Cinematography is good. There are many claustrophobic situations because the sets they designed, actually they didn't shoot inside a complete submarine. Made the set of a submarine, and every detail is astounding, and the way cinematographer has handled the scenes gives the feeling of being inside in a submarine. So I'll be giving extra marks for that. And the cinematography is good. It could have been better at one, two places, but mostly it's good. Another 1.5 out of 2. Costume designing and set location, they've done a fantastic job. See, it's not perfect, but it's good. Another 1.5 out of 2. Now coming to the special effects. Special effects I'll include it here because this film has a lot of special effects, and this is the part where it falters completely. The budget of this film is low. So we are not expecting Hollywood standards, but they could have cut off the budget from some other things and could have used it in special effects because special effects, if it would have been good, it would have improved the quality of this film a lot. The editing is average. It could have been faster certain scenes. So I'll be going with the average score of 1 by 2. So out of a cumulative score of 20, the film receives this much, and it belongs to grade this. I'll recommend this film. You can clearly go and watch this film. See, there are two kinds of audience. Who wants to watch special effects, the wonderful war sequences, the underwater sequences, the submarine sequences? Well, the submarine sequences have been shot extremely well. The war between two submarines and the visual effects are very, very poor. So those who want to see the visual effects and the high graphics, I will not recommend them to watch this film. But who wants to watch a good film and they're okay with the average visual effects and they just need to watch a good film, and it clearly deals with an important topic that has not been known to Indian audience, so I'll recommend them to watch this film. So that's it. I'll be ending my reviews right here. So if you like our videos, please like and subscribe and do share with your friends. We have sorted out the audio problem. We have got a new audio device. You might be seeing the little bulge out thing here. So it's a new microphone, and that's it. Thank you.